Morning students, today we are going to start the revision work of English 1 grammar. So the first question whichever comes in the grammar exam is comprehension. If you will see, comprehension originates from the word comprehend. Comprehend means to understand. So generally this question begins with the statement, read the passage carefully and answer the following questions. Now the main problem is how you are going to solve such questions, because generally these questions comprises of a passage which you don't know, that is unseen passage, and you need to follow it within certain time limit. First you need to see what types of questions comes or are asked in these kind of comprehension questions or unseen passage questions. So first is the title or main idea of the paragraph, contextual questions or simple interrogative questions, meanings of the word and grammar part. So this question, this idea of the paragraph or this one, this and this meaning, this should be done in last. Okay, so you will start with this question first and grammar second, because when you will start solving this contextual questions or simple interrogative questions, then you will get the basic idea. Means you will once finish reading the passage and you will know, go through what is the basic idea, what is explained in the passage, and that then you will be prepared for solving the further. And grammar part generally is given which you already know. Why I am starting with this comprehension? Because this will also give you a clear idea when you will solve the literature reader questions. Okay, when you will go through the book and you will read the passage, and there will be the questions from the text or certain portions of the text, same thing you have to do there also. Okay, so let's see what are the points which you should focus while solving it. First one, see the question, read the passage carefully and answer the following questions. Never read the passage first. What you should read first? You have to read the questions first. Then second point is you will get the idea. Now generally what happens when you will read the question first, then the question number 1 will be from the first paragraph, 2 will be from the second paragraph, 3 will be from the third paragraph, 4 will be from the fourth paragraph, then so on. So you will read the question, understand the question, go through the question one or two times, and then find the question, which point where it will be. So for first question you need to see the paragraph number 1 and 2. So very rarely it is asked from paragraph number 2, but you will, when you will go to the paragraph number 1, read it and you will find the answer with each paragraph. So you will go and find, then understand the flow, main points and structure of the passage. So while you will read, so you take a pencil on your hands and you start making the points. There is rough space in your, drawn in your book, so there a notebook. Wherever you will solve it, you find the, what is the main point written short form. Like we are preparing flowcharts in science and SST with the main points. So like this you need to write what is given, what is the name of the boy. Suppose Sundar is the name of the boy. So the boy's name is Sundar. What he does? He is a milkman. Like this you will do. Then you think of the correct options from outside the passage. Why this is? This is for the meaning of the words. You need to understand the passage in English to English, not in any other language. Then, do not rely on tricky words. Now, generally, there will be some words which you don't know the meanings of. So, you don't have to go through the dictionary. You won't find any dictionary in the examination hall. So, what you will do? You try to find out the meaning of the words. Suppose, he gave me a sack of flour. Okay, now I don't know the meaning of this word sack. So what I will do? I know that he gave me flour. Okay? So now I will start questioning myself. What he gave me? Floor. How much floor he gave me? A sack. Who gave me a sack of floor? He gave me a sack of floor. So three options I know, three answers I know. So whatever will be the question, I'll do. So main idea I know. So he gave me something, that is the main idea. What I received, that is also I know, a sack of floor. So like this, you should question yourself while reading the paragraph. Then, make notes. This is the most important thing. You need to make notes and focus on the opening and the closing of the paragraph. Now understand this better with the help of one paragraph. So like this, paragraphs will come, and this is a very big paragraph. So I'll go for a smaller one instead for today's work. So let's start with a smaller paragraph. See here, there is also story. So it is a multi-paragraph passage, and there you will find the different passages and different types of answers. So let's see why wisdom is everywhere. Now here is a title given, see, and the full paragraph is given. Now I am not reading the paragraph full. What I am doing, I am going to the question. So describe the gift that was given to Anasi. So where I will go? Once upon a time, the sky god Nayam gave Anasi an unusual gift. This is the first line. So gift is written again in the first line. It was a pot which in it all the wisdom of the world. See, what is the gift given to the Anasi? I have told you, first question, first paragraph. So I already got it was an unusual gift in which a pot was there, and which is which had the all wisdom in the world. Okay, so this way you can see. So what was the gift? A pot which had all the wisdoms of the world. So Anasi got a pot that was filled with all the wisdom of the world. So what did Anasi decide to do with the pot? Again, first two questions, first two paragraph. See, second paragraph, Anasi decided to hide the pot of wisdom on the topmost branch of a very tall tree. See, second paragraph, second question. What was the suggestion that Anasi's son gave to him? Third question, generally, third paragraph. See, he suggested, father, why don't you tie the pot on your back? Then it will be easier for you to climb the tree. So that is the suggestion. Third paragraph, third question. This is the way also you should see. Give a brief summary of the passage. Now this will be 4 and 5. What happened when Anasi dropped the pot? So here, it is on the 4th and 5th. So you will see, the pot fell into the ground and broke into the pieces. The gift of wisdom flew in every direction. People of the world found bits and pieces of wisdom that is scattered everywhere. So this happened. And now the summary. So here, first question, first two paragraphs. Last question, last two paragraphs. That is the basic. Okay. So you need to go to the basic. This is the basics. Okay. Of the questions. Now, you got an idea after solving the question that he got, Anasi got a gift. And that gift was that all the wisdom of the world. Now he doesn't want to give that wisdom to anybody. He decided to hide it. Then what happened? While doing so, the pot broke down and the wisdom was scattered everywhere. And all the people found that wisdom and people till today share this wisdom. So this is the summary. Then, second question. Find the words in the passage that means the same as this. So now, highest. While reading the passage, we know we came across the words which had the similar meaning. So you will go to this. Okay. So there will be second paragraph, you see, first word, topmost. Okay, so in a strong manner, arrived at, like this, you will find having something that belongs to you. Owning means something belonged to you. Okay. Then what was the next one? In a strong manner. So, firmly. See? Firmly, in a strong manner. Within no time. So like this, owning something that belongs to you. So having, use the word in common in a sentence that has different meaning from one of in the passage. So one word which is common, you need to find out like this. So these are the general questions which is asked, and this is done for checking your understanding of the subject. Nothing else. Okay, so you need to go through. Then the next type of question is the grammar part. See, here also new. Now you go have to go. You have already read about the adjectives. You know what is the comparative and the superlative degree. So for checking that also, we need to give the questions. Now new, amazing, difficult, strong, easier is given, so it will be easy, easiest, like this. So like this you will solve.